Arrays are perhaps the most common implementations of lists. In many programming languages, the ability to create an array is built in as a core feature. You may have seen or heard of them before, but it's important to have a more formal definition of what an array is so we can compare them to other data structures a bit later. As I mentioned before, an array is a list with a few added rules, so we already know that it has some things in some order. In some languages, you can only have objects with the same types in the same array. And in some languages, your array can contain different types, so we can't use that as a rule to define arrays. It would also be nice to say that arrays have a set size that you determine right when you create them. Again, this is only true in some programming languages, so we need to avoid adding that to our definition. Defining the thing that different languages call arrays is actually pretty hard. There is one big feature that differentiates arrays from lists. Each array has a location called an index. An index is just the number associated with that place in the array. It would make sense to number these boxes from 1 to 5, but of course it can't be that simple. Normally, an index starts at 0, so instead of referring to these boxes as 1 to 5, we usually say it's 0 to 4. Having indices can make using arrays a great, or sometimes terrible, choice for the code you're working on. If you need to access a certain location in the middle frequently, using an array can be a great choice. You just need to keep track of how long the array is, calculate the middle element, and check the object in the box with that index. Insertion and deletion can be really messy with arrays, though. Inserting in the end is often easy, but it can be hard if the array has a set size and you've already filled it up. Insertion is difficult if you want to put an element in the middle of the array. If you want to do a normal insert, you'll need to move everything after the inserted element back into different boxes with a different index. The operation as a whole is pretty inefficient since you need to move every element behind the one you're inserting back in the array. In the worst case, this operation takes linear time, or big O of n. Deletion causes a similar problem. If you delete an element, you have an empty box. You can't just look at the index and say that this is the fourth element anymore, since there's an empty box before it. Again, all of this can change based on the way a particular language implements an array, but it's important to consider when talking about arrays abstractly.